And
bees
now...
must have, hold on. We have bees. Yeah. Missing.
This is about the silver fork or knife that I stole here from the bunch of fishes. But she should calm down any minute.
Methoughts I noticing some things. Best be making sure. Some sprite or pixie played a tricks on me. There is nothing here.
Alright. And now it's a matter of waiting until she's got her back turned, and then I can move on. Right, and here we are immediately in the sewers. It's just so convenient. The note told us that we need the sewers, and here we are. However, there's a bunch of Pagans around, and this is why I'm sneaking around now. Oh yeah, I should mention it, perhaps. I still got the flu somewhat, and I may take some breaks every once in a while. And cut out some sort of coughing fits or something. Just so that you don't wonder why I may quicksave a lot this time. At weird times. It really do not make any sense at all or something. So... and this is one of the two missing objects, items that Garrett still needed. Explosive mines used to... yeah, you put them on the ground and then as soon as somebody steps onto them there will be an explosion and a fireball and a dead person. Or at least a massively wounded person. And I do not really like what they are implying here. We're in the Pagan home turf and there are mines. It's almost as if they are trying to tell us that we are supposed to, yeah, to blow up nice lovely little people like her here with our explosive mines. Speaking of her, we are now going to be delayed a little bit because I really need her wand. And I...
this?
Got it.
Who be's ballsy enough to steal my wand?
This wasn't really the stealthy and correct way to do it, but it worked, and that's all that's important. It could have gone better.
What bees I worried about.
Going to hug the wall and wait a bit, and then I'm going to drop.
Thinkers, I saw something.
This guy is Leifer, by the way. And he's got them up.
Maybe I have shaman checking on my eyes. Thems must be seeing things.
Right, normally you can take a wand from here without all this commotion in a very comfortable and easy way. But I just had to do it the hard way and screw up, didn't I? I did. So,
my eyes be tired, I guess.
Yes, his eyes be tired. Me guesses too.
Alright.
What? He seems to have a little lag there because I just was quiet when he imagined that he was seeing things
again. Just a little squirrely.
Right. Oops. Close one. Alright. Did I mention that this thing that is patrolling down there is a tree beast? I think I didn't. Pagans are really associated very often with strange creatures from the jungles or something, and Tree Beast would of course be one of the old classical sort of creatures that the pagans associate with. And here's the map.
Noisings.
Let's have a look at the map.
Well, these are just a little squirrely.
The map is very, very sophisticated and inaccurate. For instance, I know we started here, yeah? The X, of course. The fireplace was here, not there. Then, well, tunnels with pagans. The three grave robbers. The two ladies who were saying such funny things about how they can manipulate the manfools were here. And here are the sewers with the tree beast, the campfire of Leifer, and the exit to the other half of the place. And yeah, this is the main sanctuary. It was built on a hammerite factory. Actually, I think it was a mechanist factory because of the gear here. Gears are the holy symbol of the mechanist faction, and the hammer fools usually have hammers as the holy symbol. But no matter, in this abandoned hammer factory there's a training grounds. This here is the entrance from the first half. There is a creek, apparently. Barracks and a shaman and a place called the Taproot. Right. We're going to start here. Then into the Hammerful factory. Then I'm going to drop down into the creek and go to the shaman. Go to the Taproot place and the sleep sea actually shouldn't be here. It should be here. Or downstairs. Anyway, then we return and investigate here some more, and then we are going to leave. This really isn't the right place, but no, it doesn't matter. Anyway, checking how much loot I got right now. 39%, which means that I got all that I want. There be some moisings done by this tree beast. So I just move to the exit now and and leave. Here it is. So saving. The second half of the Pagan Sanctuary. Let's first get informed by reading notes. Shaman Woodbine is writing letters to all shamans. It is about the Jackknoll's paw, and you first have to do the ritual of the root before you can get the paw. Only the shamans know how this ritual is being done, which means that we have to ask her, to check her quarters for notes or something. And if you don't do that ritual, apparently it's quite lethal to try to touch the Jackknoll's paw. Apparently a pagan called Puckleaf has been deaded in this way. So
to watch for any city men who might intrude her here. Ooh, could use some knifeberry juice right about now.